issue is in today's day and age, coaches are so much online that you want a digital footprint behind any showcase or camp that you do. And what I mean by that is, let's say you do a perfect game event. So it's going to be similar structure. You're going to do your skill stuff. A lot of times there's a couple games attached to it, but you finish and you have a perfect game profile with your page, your write-up, all of your metrics. So if any coach, not just from those 20 schools, whoever was there, wants to look you up, now they can have access to all of your information. Whereas as soon as you get that info back, you can post it, but nobody believes you if it's like really good because you posted it. You know what I mean? So it's just different. They trust certain places and certain sites, and you want to utilize those as much as you can. So unless there's specific interest in like a school from there, which it sounds like there was, and that's great to go then, but don't go to those randomly without previous interaction and interest in a school.
Yeah, the only reason really that, because I've gotten those before, but the reason, like the real pull factor for this one was because I had already talked to the coaches and they
and that's exactly an opportunity to play in front of them. So that part,
right? That's exactly the way to do it. What I mean is, there's a lot of schools. I know Niagara and Canisius both did this, where they'll just every year they have a fall skills camp where you do a skills day and you play two or three games the next day, and we get 100 kids there, and our coach goes to the guys on the team and says, hey, we're looking at this guy, this guy, this guy, and this guy. Let me know what you see in this area. Let me know how he is as a person. You know, is he going to get along with the guys on the team? Right. So think about that. He tells our team, we're looking at 5 guys out of the 100 that are there. Right. So if you're not one of those 5 guys, guess what? He really, honestly, it's rude to say, but he doesn't really care that much for you. All you are is you're there to bring money to the program. And that's what we mean.
And he'll give you, and the cool thing is, like, not the cool thing, but what they'll do is they'll give you an evaluation at the end of it and say, here's how you did. And they circle a couple numbers and they're saying, you're a 3 out of 5 and you're a 4 out of 5 here. And, this is what you did and this is what you can improve on. So you leave there feeling really good. But then, like, you think that it was a recruiting opportunity and then you never get a phone call.
Mm-hmm.
And so at the end of the day, like, and I'll be the first person to say this, like, whenever I was in college recruiting, like, if I wanted to see a guy again and I was running a prospect camp, I would just literally look at the kid and say, hey, why don't you come out? I'm not going to charge you a dime. I need another opportunity to see you. And there's nothing better than seeing you on my campus. Because then, and this is another part of recruiting, once you're on my campus, it's free game. I can say whatever I want. Mm-hmm. I can offer you. I can talk to you. I can have a meeting with you. I can walk you around the campus. I can get you right there. But the hard part is if, you're just one of those dudes, they're just going to have somebody from admissions come and give you a tour around the campus. They're not going to have that individual interaction with you, so that's why I say, that's why he's saying be careful about the camps.
Right.
But there is value in it. Yes. Now understand this too. You're also not going to get an offer from anybody strictly just by going to a camp.